Ladies, gentlemen, distinguished guests, dear friends, queridos amigos, allow me to start by conveying my deep appreciation to the municipality of Barcelona for hosting us today on this important and rather sad occasion, remembering victims of road traffic crashes. I remember earlier this year when I met King Felipe. I was pleased to discuss Spain's road safety results, showing a 69% decrease in road traffic fatalities since year 2000. And I applaud your country's continuous commitment to road safety in line with Europe's vision of zero fatalities on European roads by 2050. World Day of Remembrance of Road Traffic Victims has been observed for 25 years under the leadership of the European Federation of Road Traffic Victims, FEVR. And I take this opportunity to praise FEVR for their dedication, efforts to consistently commemorate lives lost and altered, as well as loved ones impacted by tragedies on the roads. It is unacceptable that we still lose estimated 1.3 million lives on the global roads annually, while the life of over 50 million severely injured every year are never the same. The impact on their families in economical, physical, and psychological terms is unimaginable. And I highly appreciate FEVR's tireless effort to bring attention to the magnitude of the issue and to advocate for adequate support to those affected. And I want to make a special tribute to General Mersch, Manuel, and all the team who are so much involved and who are so much dedicated on this matter, which is so dear to me. This year's 10 roads with stories encompasses the reality far beyond movement and connectivity. It focuses on the concept of stories communicated to us by the roads, the experience and lessons learned, the tragedies and the pain of the loss. Roads tell us about inequality and the economic consequences on road crashes. As we know, 90% of road crashes occur in low-income countries, which only means that we need to put extra effort in countries with the highest burden. More importantly, this year's term, Roads for Stories, gives us the opportunity to create a better ending for the often traumatic ones. It provides us the opportunity to build stories of roads that fulfill their true potential. Roads that connect us to education and vital goods and services. Roads that allow us to discover, explore, grow. Roads that connect us to each other. Roads that represent hope. Since my appointment as UN Secretary General Special Envoy for Road Safety in 2015, I sincerely believe that we are beginning to see some progress. In the over 70 countries where I traveled, I met with more than 120 high-level officials who have not faltered to showcase their passion and commitment to this cause. Together with a wide range of stakeholders, we established a decade of action for road safety and integrated road safety into 2030 agenda for sustainable development and the new urban agenda. The UN General Assembly has adopted 10 road safety related resolutions since 2003, calling upon stakeholders to intensify their efforts toward improving road safety. This year, we established the first UN Road Safety Trust Fund aimed to strengthen national road safety systems. Since its launch in April this year, the Trust Fund has already generated more than $15 million in contributions and we expect these figures to grow in the coming months. Impact from the fund will only be realized if international commitment is complemented by national investments in road safety. A recent study shows that if countries do not invest in road safety, they could lose between 7 to 22% GDP growth potential. Road safety makes sense at all levels. We need to ensure measurable progress towards achieving NTJ target 3.6, calling for halving the number of victims by 2020, and 11.2, calling for universal access to safe and sustainable transport systems. Let's make our story, scaling up and aligning our efforts towards a world free of serious road traffic injuries. Let's make our story about collective actions and commitment of all stakeholders, because the toll to economics, to families, to individuals and to life is too significant. And that's the reason why I'm so happy to be with you today to celebrate the victims and to make sure that it will not happen again. Thank you.